والصلاه والسلام على سيد الانبياء والمرسلين وعلى اله واصحابه اجمعين. اما بعد، فقد قال الله تبارك وتعالى في القران المجيد والفرقان الحميد: فاعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم، بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. ظهر الفساد في البلد والبحر بما كسبت ايدينا. صدق الله العظيم. Honorable guests, respected teachers, and my dear all, my topic is corruption and its disastrous effect. Dear audience, politics is the art of ruling, and it is a noble virtue because it administers the affairs of all creatures. But absence of morals in politics has ushered in a reign of lawlessness, corruption, and all-round degradation. Selfishness and greed have crept into politics with vengeance and have made it a scourge. Corruption that breathes through the nostrils of politicians affects the Indian society in many ways. Almost all the departments of life feel its gaze. The history of the world stands a testimony to a bitter truth that politics, devoid of morals, has brought havoc and untold misery and become the harbinger of endless pain and bloodshed. Power corrupts, and absolute power corrupts absolutely. Whosoever has some power, though fake and wrong power, but he considers himself like a god, and he wants to do whatever falls to his mind. And today, absolute power is wielded by the politicians. At the time of election, they spend money ruthlessly, and they stoop to any load to please the voters. They swear to work for the welfare of their people and promise to leave no stone unturned to eliminate the poverty from the face of the country. But later on, they do not hesitate to eliminate the people themselves. They promise to bring down the heaven on this earth. In all available and possible ways, they try to befool people with their oily tongues. But once elected and taking the reins of power in their hands, they forget everything and remember their own interest only. And they start their objective is to amass wealth by hook or by crook, and they start living like ancient kings. The voters who made them kings become prowling creatures of the gutter. These worthless politicians forget that their actions would tarnish the very face of the society. Intellectual persons are kicked away and they move to foreign pastures to satiate their intellectual hunger. These political leaders are ready to make India intellectually bankrupt only to keep their position intact. They lower the morality of the nation who start imitating their political bosses. Officials to adopt immoral methods to amass wealth. Corruption becomes the rule, and this results into distortion of values. People start justifying evil by saying that it is found everywhere. Gangsters are hired to eliminate adversaries, and the nexus between politicians and underworld dons is no secret today. Law and order suffer, bribery rules, extortion and kidnapping come in vogue, and anarchy prevails everywhere. All social organizations get polluted when corrupting hands of politicians touch them. Scandals and scams take place. The economic damage to the nation is beyond description. The corrupt politicians deposit their loot in the Swiss bank. They do not believe in the maxim, you shall reap as you sow. A corrupt politician becomes a monster. He believes in contrary things. If character is lost, nothing is lost. If health is lost, something is lost. And if wealth is lost, everything is lost. Political corruption in the ancient times was limited. Religion still ruled over the hearts of the people, and people were still God-fearing, and they believed in the maxim, you shall reap as you sow. Religious reasons nullified the effect and influence of unethical practices. And they were still God-fearing, and the masses were not corrupt. Our brilliant history is full of many rulers who embraced righteousness later on and worked for the welfare of their people. But today, these politicians who are the virtual rulers have no conscience to re-embrace righteousness. They are really the incarnation of Satan, and they are thoroughly self-centered, selfish, and have no sentiment of common good. They are not allowing India to get back her lost glory, and they have planned corruption to each and every nook and corner of India. To rid the society of the Frankenstein monster of corruption, the Swiss society in the form of Anna Hazare and Baba Ramdev has come to the fore. Let alone whether they are sincere or not, they might be selfish or opportunist, but this is just a beginning. Now the people are getting conscious towards corruption, and this may become the harbinger of great upheaval and revolution. We must see eye to eye with them. We must create political awareness among our society and community. We must wield the power of non-violence, and we must be careful when we press the button of EVM, because the candidate will become our representation. Pious, God-fearing, religious, and righteous people should come to the politics to change the whole system and to sanitize it. But only this will not root out the corruption until our schools, colleges, and houses are sanitized by moral teaching, and until there is a moral rearmament movement to make Indian society free from corruption in all its forms. Then the revolution will see its dawn, and corruption-free India may become superpower within only 10 years, because it has countless natural resources and hard-working and striving people. The only obstacle is corruption, and we all together have to fight it collectively. And here I conclude my speech.